Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and start doing a record here and talk some more about this web captioner that I've had here since yesterday. This has to be one of the coolest tools for vMix I've ever come across. I don't know what that's called, but it's amazing. And if you say something that's perhaps a little bit off from what it knows, it will try to correct it to what it should be. Now, yesterday we were trying NDI. Now, it's still doing NDI. That's Network Device Interface. That's in vMix that I'm using to bring this in from a second computer over to the main vMix computer. It's, again, Network Device Interface. And I'll put some links down below to Web Captioner and vMix, so you can take a look. vMix, again, has a 60-day free trial that you can use. It has no watermark. And you can do everything with it that big video recorders and streamers do with their video streamers and recorders. But again, vMix is a cool, cool tool. But again, I'm talking about web captioner and some things you can use it for. And for one, it's someone like me that's extremely hard of hearing to have a video captioned. When I watch it, it's just heaven. Now, if I watch it something on Amazon or Hulu or Netflix, I use the captions on it so I can see what's going on in the story. But so many times on YouTube videos, there's you can use the automatic captioner. I've used that on my video. And it does about the same quality job of depicting or showing what I said as web captioning. I mean, it doesn't get everything exactly right that I said or tried to say. The thing about that, my speech isn't all that good. So anyway. But for someone's hard of hearing, the captions just make life a lot easier to watch the video on YouTube or watch it anyplace else. But again, this web captioner is just one of the dandiest tools I've came across that I can use with vMix, there you go. That I've ever tried to use with any video or any video recorder, but video recorder. that's better. But again, a guy sent this to me, and on the vMix forums, and you can go up there and check it out, try it, download it. It's listed in the vMix forums as, what is that listed as? Let's see. Hang with me. We're going to see if I can't figure out what I put that up as in vMix form. I can't see vMix video. But anyway. I a new version of vMix out, maybe. I don't remember. But it's automatic web captioning or something like that. And, but again, it's the coolest tool that I've ever that I've ever tried to use. I didn't say Arizona. I don't know where Arizona came in at. I don't have any idea what, how that got in this caption, but it did. So, Catherine, no, I didn't say anything. But again, it's it gives what 90% right on what you try to say, and right in the captions, which isn't bad. But again, it won't do NDI. It won't do NDI. NDI. There it is. NDI. Maybe. NDI. I don't know. I just don't look at it. But Web Device Interface, again, that's what I'm using to bring this in from a second lap. From a separate laptop, and what I'm doing, I'm just using the microphone on the computer that's built into the computer to pick up what I'm trying to say. Maybe if I had a actual mic in there, maybe it might be better. I'll try that in a few minutes, see if that helps correct, make what I'm saying a little more correct, but again, this is really a neat tool, and if you want to do web captions on your videos, do check it out. Now, what somebody said, if you could record two streams at one time, you could do one of captions and one of outs, and people could pick the stream that they wanted to watch or listen to. So what kind of uses would you think this might have for different folks around the web? Another one was in conferences on a large screen. Can you imagine putting the web captioner on that large screen so people could, well, not everybody goes to conferences here well, so they could see what was being said. And sometimes if you sit in the back of the room, the audio isn't all that good anyway. And so you could see what was said in that conference. That's two uses, I think. Someone's hard of hearing like me, and web conferences. But there were some other things they thought about yesterday that perhaps people could use, would need this for, would use it for. And again, if you're doing captioning on your video, then you're going to get, perhaps on YouTube, you're going to get a lot more viewers, because people who can't hear well are going to be able to watch your video. I don't know what salt is doing in there, but again, it's again, a web tool, and you can check down in the description here. Oh, if you use a web captioner, you got to use Chrome. You can't use a Microsoft browser with it. But anyway, you need to really check it out, and it's just, again, one of the neatest tools I've ever used a vMix. Now, vMix has some other tools. Let's see here. The video chat That's a neat tool built in where you can bring another party into your vMix and do review interviews and things like that with them. But and again, the NDI that they put in on, I think it was on version 9.18 maybe. But again, I hope vMix grabs this up and makes it part of vMix. I think it would be very cool. vMix. There you go. It got vMix. So, again, I hope the folks down in Australia will, again, consider making this part of version 20 vMix, and perhaps I hope they don't cut anybody out of using it, like the lowest tier on the board as far as who they sell it to, a $60 package, it's SD, but $60 package. There you go, a $60 package. It's a $60 package. $60 package. But I think I'm going to quit while I'm ahead here. But again, this web captioner, there's a link to it in the description in the video below here. And you might be able to find it other places on the web. It's listed in the vMix forms. I don't know why I can't get but if you go up there, you can find it. Maybe it's captioned. Again, I'm going to check out and see what the new version of vMix is that just came out. They've got a change log up here. And so basically, I'm going to check that out and see what's going on. But we're using version 64 now. And this is version 19.0.0.3.7. I'm going to check that out and download it and get it installed and vMix. If you have any questions about Web Captioner or anything else like that, let me know. There we go. Well, if you have any questions about Web Captioner, ask me. I've been using it for a few days, and I can tell you what I know about it. Somebody wanted to know how many of this text it saved, and someone said it saved 1,000. in the text that you just done. So if you do a new one, you're going to lose it, but it would save 1,000 characters in the chat that you could use to paste someplace else. And he's going to work on that. He's going to make that better. He's going to make it so you can set up how many characters you want to save, and some other things he plans on doing to enhance web capture. So for me here in Pendleton, Indiana, this is George Price.